Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on solution and discussion on gate question paper in Mechanical Engineering subject. This is lecture number 31. We are going to solve problems and discuss the solution in the conduction heat transfer. The thermal conductivity is lower for wood, air, water at 100 degrees Celsius and steam at 1 bar. Among the four options, we have to find out the material or item with the lowest thermal conductivity. The extract of the heat and mass transfer data book, the data of thermal conductivity of the different material given here are displayed here. For wood, it is 0.1 watts per meter Kelvin, air 0.02675 watts per meter Kelvin, water at 100 degrees Celsius, it is 0.6804, and steam at 1 bar 0.02373. So, among the four values, the lowest value is for steam at 1 bar, which is 0.02373 watts per meter Kelvin. The next question, two insulating material of thermal conductivity K and 2K are available for lagging pipe, lagging a pipe carrying hot fluid. If the radial thickness of each material is the same, so we have four options, we have to select the correct answer. Material with higher thermal conductivity should be used for the inner layer and one with lower thermal conductivity for the outer layer. Material with lower thermal conductivity should be used in the inner layer and one with higher thermal conductivity for the outer layer. It is immaterial in which sequence the insulating material are used. It is not possible to judge unless the numerical value of the dimensions are given. So, the correct way of lagging the insulating material. So, material with lower thermal conductivity should be used for the inner layer and one with higher thermal conductivity for the outer layer. So, that is the sequence. So, then the heat transfer will be lower. For a given heat flow and for the same thickness, the temperature drop across the material will be maximum for copper, steel, glass wool, refractory brick. So, the temperature drop delta T value will be maximum for which material? So, the temperature distribution T1 minus T2 that is equal to QL by KA. So, here for the same thickness and the heat transfer, so QLA the parameters are constant and the parameter which is variable is thermal conductivity. So, K is the thermal conductivity which is the governing parameter. So, the K is in the denominator. So, the temperature drop will be maximum when the denominator is minimum. So, for the given parameter, so constant value of Q, L and K, when the thermal conductivity K is minimum, the temperature drop will be maximum. So, among the four material, glass wool has got the lowest thermal conductivity. So, the answer is glass wool, so which will give the maximum temperature drop. In descending order of magnitude, thermal conductivity of material A, pure ion, material B, liquid water, material C, saturated water vapor, and material D, pure aluminium can be arranged as four options are given here, A, B, C, D, B, C, A, D, D, A, B, C, D, C, B, A. So, the descending order, higher value, first higher value, then succeeding value will be lower. So, that is what the descending order. So, there are four material, pure ion 72.7, liquid water 0.628, saturated water vapor 0.02373 and the pure aluminium 204.2. So, A is the pure ion. So, that is not the highest value. So, A is option A is dropped. B is dropped. There are two correct value. So, the correct value order, correct order is aluminium, pure ion. So, D, A, B, C. So DABC is the correct order. So DABC option C is the correct answer. So one dimensional unsteady state heat transfer equation for a sphere with heat generation rate QG can be written as. So we have four options. One dimensional unsteady state heat transfer for sphere with internal heat generation QG. So the 1 by R, dou by dou R, R into dou T by dou R, so that the equation is dropped. So the, because it is dou T, so for sphere it should be R square. So reading the value B, 1 by R square dou by dou R square dou T by dou R plus Q by K equal to 1 by alpha dou T by dou T. So C, option C is dropped. Option D is also not correct. So option D is C and D are correct, incorrect. So the correct answer is option B for the sphere. So 1 by R square dou by dou R square into dou T by dou R plus Q by K, Q dot by K or QG by K equal to 1 by alpha dou T by dou T. That is the one dimensional unsteady state heat transfer equation for a sphere with the internal heat generation at the rate of QG. In the case of one dimensional heat conduction in a medium with the constant properties, T is the temperature at any position x at the time t, then dou T by dou T, the temperature variation with respect to time is proportional to. So for one dimensional heat conduction in a medium with the constant properties, we have four options: T by x, dou T by dou x, dou square T by dou x dou y, dou square T by dou x, x is dou square T by dou x square. So one dimensional unsteady state heat transfer in a slab, the governing equation is dou square T by dou x square equal to 1 by alpha dou T by dou T. So dou T by dou T is proportional to dou square T by dou x square. So the answer is D. D, option D is the correct answer. So the temperature variation with respect to time, dou T by dou T is proportional to dou square T by dou x square for a constant value of thermal diffusivity alpha. Next question from 2005 question paper. A well machined steel plate of thickness L is kept in such that the wall temperature are TH and TC as shown in the figure below. A smooth copper plate of the same thickness L is now attached to the steel plate without any gap as indicated in the figure below. There are two figures shown here. First we have a steel plate and second we have a steel plate and a copper plate. The temperature at the interface is Ti. The temperature of the outer wall are still the same, TH and TC. The heat transfer rate Q1 and Q2 per unit area for the two cases respectively in the direction shown. So, which of the following statement is correct? So, TH is greater than TI is greater than TC and Q1 is less than Q2. TH is less than TI less than TC and Q1 is equal to Q2. TH is equal to TI plus TC divided by 2 and Q1 is greater than Q2. TI is less than TH plus TC divided by 2 and Q1 is greater than Q2. So the correct answer is option D. So TI is greater than, less than TH plus TC divided by 2 and Q1 is greater than Q2. So we will see how in the next slide. So this is the two arrangement. First we calculate the heat transfer. So Q1 for the first slab, Q1 equal to TH minus TC divided by RS. So RS is the resistance due to the steel. For the second case, Q2 equal to TH minus TC divided by RS plus RC. So RS is the resistance due to the steel and RC is the resistance due to the copper plate. So we have two resistance in the second case. RS plus RC is greater than RS. So Q1 is greater than Q2. That is the first condition. Heat transfer Q1. So for the first slab, the heat transfer is more than the second slab. Then thermal resistance. So the LS by KS is greater than LC by KC. So what is LS? So this LS actually the thermal conductivity of the steel is less than thermal conductivity of the copper. So LS by, so for the same value of L, LS by KS is greater than LC by KC. So RS is greater than RC because thermal conductivity for the copper is higher. than the steel. So RS, so from this equation RS equal to TH minus TA. So since RS is greater than RC, TH minus TI is greater than TI minus TC, because RS, so the temperature difference divided by the resistance equal to the heat transfer. So the TH minus TI is greater than TI minus TC. So rearranging the terms, TH plus TC is greater than 2 times of TI. So TH plus TC divided by 2 is greater than TI, or TI is less than TH plus TC divided by 2. So the option D, what we have selected here, it gives the correct answer. So the option D. Next question from 2006 question paper. In a composite slab, the temperature at the interface is T interface between two material is equal to the average temperature of the two ends. Assuming one dimensional heat conduction, which of the following statement is true about the respective thermal conductivity? We have four options: 2K1 equal to K2, K1 equal to K2, 2K1 equal to 3K2, and K1 equal to 2K2. And look at the geometry. 2B is the thickness of the first slab with thermal conductivity K1. B is the thickness of the second slab with thermal conductivity K2. And the temperature, terminal temperatures are T1 and T2. The correct answer is K1 equal to 2 times of K2. So K1 is the thermal conductivity of the first slab is 2 times of the thermal conductivity of the second slab. We will see how. So this is the arrangement shown here. The same diagram is repeated here. We have two resistances. So R1 and R2. R1 is the resistance due to the first slab. R2 is the resistance due to the second slab. And the heat transfer Q equal to T1 minus TI divided by R1 equal to TI minus T2 divided by R2. Now cross multiplying the value, R2 into T1 minus TI is equal to R1 into TI minus T2. So rearranging the terms, TI into R1 plus R2 equal to R1 T2 plus R2 T1. So the interface temperature TI equal to R1 T2 plus R2 T1 divided by R1 plus R2. Now we assume the resistances are equal. R1 is equal to R2. Substituting for R1, resistance of the first slab, L by KA, that is the resistance value. So 2B divided by K1 into A. And resistance for the second slab, so thickness is B. So B divided by K2 into A. So in both sides, B and A, capital A, they are getting cancelled. So we are left out with the 2 by K1 is equal to 1 by K2. So cross multiplying once again, K1 equal to 2 times of K2. So that is the answer. So thermal conductivity of the first slab is equal to 2 times the thermal conductivity of the second slab. Next question from 2011 question paper, a pipe of 25 millimeter outer diameter carries steam. The heat transfer coefficient between the cylinder and the surrounding is 5 watts per meter square Kelvin. It is proposed to reduce the heat loss from the pipe by adding insulation having thermal conductivity 0.05 watts per meter Kelvin. Which one of the following statement is true? There are four options given. Option A, the outer radius of the pipe is equal to the critical radius of the critical radius. Option B, the outer radius of the pipe is less than the critical radius. Adding insulation will reduce the heat loss. Adding insulation will increase the heat transfer. So the adding insulation will reduce the heat loss. That is the correct answer. So we will see how in the next slide. So we have the outer radius RO equal to 12.5 millimeter. Heat transfer coefficient H equal to 5 watts per meter square Kelvin. Thermal conductivity K equal to 0.05 watts per meter Kelvin. And the critical radius of insulation. So RC equal to K by H. So K equal to 0.05 divided by 5 equal to 0.01 meter, which is 10 millimeter. So if RC is less than RO, critical radius is less than RO, then the heat transfer will decrease. So if the wire radius is more than the critical radius of the critical layers, then the addition of insulation will reduce the heat transfer, causes overheating of the wire or the cable. So that is what the answer. So option C is the answer. Next question from 2013 question paper. Consider one dimensional steady state heat conduction without heat generation near plane wall with the boundary conditions as shown in the figure below. The conductivity of the wall is given by K equal to KO plus BT, where KO and B are the positive constant, T is the temperature. So you look at the diagram. So we have T1 on the left hand side. We have the certain thickness of the slab. X is measured from the left side. X is increasing in this direction. So T2 is the temperature on the right side surface. And here T2 is greater than T1. So look at the value. T2 is greater than T1 and X is measured from the left side. The X increases. The temperature, the state temperature gradient dT by dx will remain constant. B0 increases or decreases. Increase or decrease. So for this arrangement, what will happen to the temperature gradient dT by dx? The answer is option D, decrease. We will see how in the next slide. So this is what we discussed in the theory. So the temperature gradient here, dT by dx. So temperature on the left hand side, right hand side is lower. Temperature on the left hand side is higher, T1. So the heat is transferred from the left side to the right side. So temperature gradient is increasing. Whereas here, the temperature gradient T2 is greater than T1. So here the temperature gradient dT by dx is decreasing. The next question, again from 2013 question paper. Consider one-dimensional steady state heat conduction along the x-axis. X is less than or equal to L, greater than or equal to 0. Through a plane wall with a boundary surface x equal to 0 and x equal to L, maintained at a temperature of 0 degree Celsius and 100 degree Celsius. The heat generated uniformly throughout the wall. Choose the correct statement. The direction of heat transfer will be from the surface at 100 degree Celsius to the surface at 0 degree Celsius. The maximum temperature inside the wall must be greater than 100 degree Celsius. The temperature distribution is linear within the wall. The temperature distribution is symmetric about the midplane of the wall. So the first answer, so because there is heat generation within the slab, so the option A is not correct. Option C is also not correct. It's not, the temperature distribution is not linear and the heat is not transferred from 100 degree Celsius to 0 degree Celsius because there is internal heat generation. So there are two options left out, B and D. So the temperature distribution is symmetrical about the midplane. So this temperature distribution will be symmetrical only when the two surfaces are at the same temperature. So here one surface is at 0 degree Celsius, another surface is 100 degree Celsius. So the correct answer among the four options are, the maximum temperature inside the wall must be greater than 100 degree Celsius. So I will display a small diagram. So this is the diagram for internal heat temperature distribution for internal heat generation. The right side wall is at 100 degree Celsius, left side wall is at 0 degree Celsius, and here this is the maximum temperature. So the peak value is maximum temperature, which is slightly higher than 100 degree Celsius. So the maximum temperature is higher than the 100 degree Celsius. That is the option, correct answer given among the four alternatives. The next question from 2014 question paper. Consider a long cylindrical tube of inner and outer radii Ri and Ro respectively. Length L and thermal conductivity K. Its inner and the outer surface are maintained temperature Ti and To respectively, and Ti is greater than To. Assuming one dimensional steady state heat conduction in radial direction, the thermal resistance in the wall of the tube is. There are four options. Option A, 1 by 2 pi KL logarithmic of Ri by Ro. Option B, L by 2 pi Ri into K. Option C, 1 by 2 pi KL into logarithmic of Ro by Ri. And option D, 1 by 4 pi KL into logarithmic of Ro by Ri. So the option B and D, they are dropped. So they are irrelevant to the geometry. So 4 pi is not here, only 2 pi, either option A or option C. So this is the cylinder, cylindrical system, heat transfer in the cylindrical system, and the resistance for a hollow cylinder. So Ti is the inner surface temperature, T1 is the inner surface temperature, or Ti here, Ti and To are the surface temperature. The resistance equal to 1 by 2 pi KL into logarithmic of R2 by R1. So R2 equal to RO and R1 equal to RI. So the heat transfer Q equal to T1 minus T2 divided by 1 by 2 pi KL logarithmic of R2 by R1. So the correct answer is option C, 1 by 2 pi KL into logarithmic of RO by RI. RO is R2 and RI equal to R1, inner radius, outer radius. As the temperature increases, the thermal conductivity of gas, there are four options: increases, decreases, remain constant, increases up to certain temperature, and then decreases. So the for gas, when the temperature increases, thermal conductivity of the gas will increase, because the molecule, the random movement of the particle molecules are increasing, so thermal conductivity will increase. The next question from 2015 question paper: if a foam insulation is added to a 4 cm outer diameter pipe as shown in the figure, the critical radius of insulation is dash centimeter. So the critical radius of insulation, so the diameter here is 4 cm, so the critical radius of insulation equal to RC equal to K by H. So K by H equal to, K is the thermal conductivity of the insulation. So for the insulation, thermal conductivity is 0.1 divided by H is the heat transfer coefficient, which is given as 2 watts per meter square Kelvin. So 0.1 divided by 2 equal to 0.05 meter, which is 5 centimeter. So the answer is 5 centimeter. The critical radius of insulation equal to 5 centimeter. The next question is from 2016 question paper: a plastic sleeve of outer radius RO equal to 1 millimeter covers a wire of radius 0.5 millimeter carrying electric current. Thermal conductivity of the plastic is 0.15 watts per meter Kelvin. The heat transfer coefficient on the outer surface of the sleeve is exposed to the air is 25 watts per meter square Kelvin. Due to the addition of plastic cover, the heat transfer from the wire to the ambient will increase, remain same, decrease, be zero. The correct answer is increase. So because of the plastic cover, the heat transfer from the wire will increase. We'll see how in the next slide. So wire radius RI equal to 0.5 millimeter, outer radius is RO equal to 1 millimeter. So the heat transfer coefficient H equal to 25 watts per meter square Kelvin. Thermal conductivity is 0.15 watts per meter Kelvin, and the critical radius of insulation for the given condition, RC equal to K by H, so 0.15 divided by 25 equal to 0.006 meter, which is 6 millimeter. So the RC, critical radius of the wire, critical radius of insulation RC is greater than RO, RO equal to 1 millimeter, so the heat transfer will increase. So RC is greater than RO. So the heat transfer will increase. That is the answer to the question. Next question from 2016 question paper: a hollow cylinder has a length of L, inner radius R1, outer radius R2, thermal conductivity K. The thermal resistance for the cylindrical system. So we have logarithmic of R2 by R1 into 1 by 2 divided by 1 by 2 pi KL, logarithmic of R1 by R2 divided by 1 by 2 pi KL. Or 2 pi KL divided by logarithmic of R1 by R2, or 2 pi KL divided by logarithmic of R2 by R1. The same question we have brought here, and the arrangement, cylindrical system, the thermal resistance and the circuit is given, and the heat transfer denominator is the thermal resistance. The correct answer is option A, logarithmic of R2 by R1 divided by 2 pi KL. That is the answer, thermal resistance for the cylindrical system. The next question from 2016 question paper: steady one-dimensional heat conduction takes place across phase 1 and 3 of the composite slab consisting of slab A and B in perfect contact as shown in the figure, where Ka, Kb denote the respective thermal conductivities. Using the data given in the figure, the interface temperature T2 is dash degree Celsius. So, we are given T1 equal to 130 degree Celsius, Ka equal to 20 watts per meter Kelvin, Kb equal to 100 watts per meter Kelvin, and T3 equal to 30 degree Celsius. A thickness of the slab A is 0.1 meter, thickness of the slab B is 0.3 meter. Now, we calculate the heat transfer, Q equal to T1 minus T3 divided by resistances for constant value of A, heat transfer per unit area, LA by KA plus LB by KB, substituting 130 minus 30 divided by 0.1 divided by 20 plus 0.3 divided by 100 equal to 12,500 watts per meter square. To calculate the interface temperature, we take the first slab. So, the heat transfer Q equal to T1 minus T divided by LA by KA, the first resistance. So, 130 minus T divided by 0.1 divided by 20 equal to 12,500. So, the temperature T equal to 67.5 degree Celsius. 67.5 degree Celsius. The next question from 2017 question paper. A metallic cylinder casing of an exhaust pipe has inner radius 50 millimeter, wall thickness 7 mm. If thermal conductivity of the material of the casing is 50 watts per meter Kelvin, then the thermal resistance of the casing is given is dash Kelvin by kilowatt up to 3 decimal places. So, we have to calculate the thermal resistance for the cylindrical system. This is the arrangement for the cylindrical system and the value of resistance is shown here. And inner radius R1 equal to 0.05 meter, outer radius equal to inner radius plus thickness of the wall thickness. So, 0.05 plus 0.007 equal to 0.057 meter. Thermal conductivity 50 watts per meter Kelvin, which is 0.05 kilowatt per meter Kelvin. We are converting into kilowatt because here we have to calculate resistance in kilowatt. So, calculating thermal resistance, R equal to 1 by 2 pi KL, logarithmic of R2 by R1. So, R equal to 1 by 2 pi into K equal to 0.05 into 1, length equal to 1 meter, and logarithmic of 0.057 divided by 0.05 equal to 0.417 Kelvin by kilowatt. So, the answer is 0.0417 Kelvin per kilowatt. Next question from 2019 question paper. A slender rod of length L, diameter D, where length is very much greater than diameter and thermal conductivity K1 is joined with another rod of identical dimension but of thermal conductivity K2 to form a composite cylindrical rod of length 2L. The heat transfer in the radial direction and contact resistance are negligible. Effective thermal conductivity of the composite rod A, 2K1K2 plus K1 plus K2. B, square root of K1, K2, C, K1 plus K2, D, K1, K2 divided by K1 plus K2. So, the answer is A, 2K1, K2 divided by K1 plus K2. We will see how in the next slide. So, this is the composite cylindrical rod. So, first rod of resistance R1, second rod of resistance R2, they are connected. So, the heat transfer rate T1 minus T3 divided by L1 by AK1 plus L2 by AK2. So, this is equal to, when you have a equivalent resistance, this is equal to T1 minus T3 divided by 2L divided by A into K equivalent. So, the denominators are equal. So, for the same heat transfer, numerator is the same, denominator is also equal. L by AK1 plus L by AK2 equal to 2L by A into K equivalent. So, A is getting cancelled. So, L by K1 plus L by K2 equal to 2L by K equivalent. So, you take K1 common denominator, K1, K2 into L of K1 plus K2 equal to 2L by K equivalent. L is also getting cancelled. So, K1 plus K2 divided by K1, K2 equal to 2 by K equivalent. So, K equivalent equal to 2K1, K2 divided by K1 plus K2. That is the answer to the problem. Next question, one-dimensional steady-state heat conduction takes place through a solid whose cross-sectional area varies linearly in the direction of heat transfer. assuming there is no heat generation in the solid and thermal conductivity of the material is constant and independent of temperature. The temperature distribution of the solid is linear, logarithmic, quadratic, exponential. The answer is logarithmic. So, we will see how in the next slide. Area is linearly varying with the x. So, A equal to Cx. So, the heat transfer Q equal to minus Ka dT by dx. So, substituting for A, minus K into Cx into dT by dx. So, rearranging the terms. You are taking these two terms, rearranging the term dT equal to Q minus Q by Kc into dx by x. Integrating this equation, T equal to minus Q by Kc log x plus C1. So, this is the temperature distribution and we have a logarithmic term here. So, the temperature distribution is logarithmic, varying logarithmically. That is the answer to the problem. So, temperature profile is logarithmic. That is the answer. Next question from 1991 question paper. So, we have to match the table. Left hand side we have the properties. Right hand side we have the unit. We have to match. So, bulk modulus newtons per meter square. Thermal conductivity watts per meter Kelvin. So, heat transfer coefficient watts per meter square Kelvin. And heat flow rate equal to watts. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I have published in mechanical engineering subject. You can use the book for your better preparation. Also, I upload the video lectures on the subjects mentioned here and a solution to the gate question paper. You subscribe the channel. Use the videos for your better preparation and to pass in the gate examination. So, thank you for watching. You please post your comments on the comments box. You contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for all your queries on the subject. So, thank you. We will continue the solution in conduction heat transfer in next slide also.